Hello, my name is Syakir Zufairi bin Muhammad Abdul. My matrix number is 2021-208-232. I am from class E. I am from Faculty of Business Management.
Okay, hi, this is me, Syakir Zufairi bin Muhammad Dul, and this is my family. I have 5 siblings. There are 3 boys and 2 girls, and I am the eldest one. Then, this is the true person that I love so much. That is my father and my mother. My father's name is Muhammad Dul bin Muhammad, and my mother's name is Sarina binti Sulaiman. Okay, this is my brother. His name is Nabil Kushairi. I call him Dede. And this is his twins. Her name is Nabila Yohanis. I call her Kakak.
Wait a minute! Who are you?
Okay, next. Her name is Samira Yohanis. I call her Ate. And she is my youngest sister. The youngest in my sibling is Hazim Huzairi. I call him Adik. Okay, that's all for my family background.
Oh my god! Wow!
I think you guys want to know more about my background yet. So, stay watch my video and let me tell you about my other background. First of all, I was born on 15th of February 2003 at Hospital Tengku Ampuan Afzan Kuantan. Okay, this is my hobby. My hobbies are playing futsal and playing sepak takraw with my friends every day. Last but not least, this is my ambition. I want to be a CEO. CEO is a short form for Chief Executive Officer. Okay, next, let me tell you about my study background. I start my study at Tadika Permata Ibu when I was 5 and 6 years old. I continue my study at SK Gambang when I was 7 years old until 12 years old. Then, when I was at the secondary school, I studied at SMK Gambang for 2 years and moved to SMK Seri Mahkota for 3 years. Now, I study at UiTM Junker Campus Pahang. That's all for my background that you need to know. I hope you guys can know me better after this.
Okay.
Hi, for my semester 1 at UiTM, I have learned a subject called UED 102. Subject UED 102 is an important learning skill for every student in going through university life well. This is content of UED 102. There are 6 chapters in the UED 102 subject.
Please, I don't have any time for any gossip now. Yes.
Look at you.
For the first chapter, getting ready to learn, I have learned making the transition from school to university. There are many differences between high school and university. I know making the move from being in a school to university is not an easy task. There is a need for students to make a new friends, find out new things, and make necessary lifestyle adjustment for them to feel at home in the new surroundings. To adapt to a new life is hard, but it is worth experience. for the second chapter, goal setting. Goal setting is a process for thinking about your ideal future and for motivating yourself to turn this vision of the future into reality. The process of goal setting will help you where you want to go in life. Properly, to set goals can be incredibly motivating, and as you get into the habit of setting and achieving goals, you will find yourself confident built fast. There is 5 steps approach to setting goals. First, tentative goal statement. Second, list of obstacles. Third, list of resources. Next, revise goal statement. And last, polish goal statement. For the third chapter, time management, I have learned time management is the ability to weigh one's time effectively of the productivity, especially work. Each student is encouraged to do effective time management and create daily schedule. If the students manage their time goodly, they can divide the time to systematically review subjects. They can train and discipline themselves in timeline manner. Time travel will be more organized and manageable. They can driving towards the achievement of excellence in the field of engagement. They can avoid long-acting practice for doing something. And last, they can balance the time division between learning time and leisure time. After learning this chapter, I have made my own timetable and daily planner. For the chapter 4, memory, learning, and improving concentration, there are 3 types of memory. First, sensory memory. Second, short-term memory. And last, long-term memory. There are 5 ways to improve our memory strategies. It is manage your time wisely, repeat the information many times, elaboration strategies, organize the material, and comprehension monitoring strategies. For the next chapter, taking lecturer notes, I have learned how to take corner note, mind mapping, and use 2 column method.
Good job.
For the last topic, chapter 6, academic integrity and performance, I have learned avoiding plagiarism and calculation grade point average. Plagiarism is presenting someone else's words or idea as if they were your own. This is type of plagiarism. GPA. GPA stands for grade point average. GPA show average of your grades in all your course. GPA is important because college, scholarship, commits, and employers will judge your application based on criteria including your GPA. This is GPA calculation process.
COVID-19 di negara kita. Sekolah, universiti dan sebahagian pejabat, premis perniagaan dan kilang ditutup.
Okay guys, for my first semester at UiTM Jengke Campus Pahang, I need to ODL method for my class. What is ODL? ODL is Open Distance Learning, and a system of education in which education is imparted to learners who may not be physically present on campus. Its philosophy is to remove barriers to education and allow learners to study according to their time, pace, and place. Okay guys, today I want to tell you what's my challenging and obstacles during my ODL and how to I overcome it. My first obstacle during ODL is I always have a network problem. It is disturbed me when I was in the class. So I go to my auntie's house or go to the cyber cafe to get the good internet and access it. Secondly, I always late wake up every day and often miss my class. So I overcome it with set a alarm to wake up earlier every day.
No, God, please, no, no, no.
Lastly, I always did not understood what my lecturer teach in the class. It is because there are many interference around me from my siblings and friends. So I overcome it with do a revision and take a note. Okay guys, thank you for watching. Bye.